I am Ranveer Singh.
I feel incredibly blessed to be where I am today. Films are revered in India. So every young person in India wants to be a hero. You know, in India, they don't call them actors, they call them heroes. And for somebody in my position, an outsider, it was near to impossible to actually get a foot into the Hindi film industry, because you could only become a leading man if you had a familial connection, or if you were the son of a producer or a director, or you were a star kid. If you think about it realistically, I couldn't get there. Around the age of 15, I sort of abandoned my dream of becoming an actor and I pursued becoming a copywriter. I went to America to study advertising. I think in the second year, by chance, I took an acting course. And on the first day, the instructor said, "I don't want to know who you are or where you're from. I just want you to get up in front of the class and perform." And when I went up and I started reciting a famous monologue, and it was in Hindi, and nobody in the class understood Hindi, but I said it with a great deal of passion. So everybody was taken aback.
And when I saw that I could perform
and evoke an emotional reaction out of a viewing audience, it was beautiful.
I felt that rush.
And I sat back in my seat and I said, why am I not doing this? I can accept failing, but I can't accept not trying. So I called my dad and I said, this is what I want to do. So he said, one condition, you complete your education so you have something to fall back on. So I finished my education and I came back and I was like, well, here I am. But how do I do this? I have no idea. I thought maybe I should get a job which takes me to an actual film set. At least I'll be closer to films. So I went to that set thinking maybe I'll be attracted to being a cameraman, a technician, or an editor. We were shooting that day in an auditorium. I looked from right to left, and all the work that goes into a production was going on. And there was the mark of the actor. And that superstar used to walk in with that kind of charismatic aura, how he goes inside and he gets ready, comes out, he's in character, and then he goes and he performs and everybody loves it and he spreads cheer and happiness. And I was like, there, that's where I need to be. So I tried to join a theater group. No theater group wanted me, but I used to make myself useful. I used to pull up chairs for people and bring the actors tea, turn the lights off, till the point that I became indispensable to that theater group. I used to put the set up, break the set down, load big trunks into the truck. I was basically the runner. And I remember sitting outside and they said, oh, you know what? There's a film being shot next door. And I was like, what am I doing here? So I had to make a calling card, what they call the actor's portfolio, you know, headshots. I pulled a favor from my father's friend who had a printing press. I would go to his place in the middle of the night, take those pictures, make them myself. I used to steal numbers from people's phones to call filmmakers. I used to go from office to office, waiting for them all day, give my portfolio hope that I'd get a call back. I faced a lot of rejection, a lot of humiliation. It was a difficult period. I had dedicated my life to this and it just seemed like it would never happen. I don't know what was driving me. I think it was just self-belief. I believed that I was good. And one day I got a call and they said, it's for this audition. And they were actually looking for a new face. This is it. This is the day you've been waiting for. It's right there and you have to seize it. There is a Gurudwara on the way. I went to that Gurudwara and that audition went well. The biggest break that one could possibly imagine, I had just got. My legs gave way and I slumped down to my knees and I started bawling. I went to my best friend's house. She was actually the one who got me the audition. And I showed her the script in my hand. I was like, look at this. I was like, can you believe this? Went to the church and said, thank you. And I'll never forget that day. We celebrated, we danced, and then I did the movie and it became a hit. There was just an avalanche of attention. They were like, who is this new guy? He's an amazing actor. And it was overnight. Friday the movie released, on Monday I was famous. And the next thing you know, I find myself at an awards function receiving the best debut award from a mega star. It was like a dream. When I'm on a film set, at least once a day, I have some experience, like some fan interaction or a moment on the film set or something happens almost every day. It gives me that same surreal feeling, which makes me feel like I'm living a dream. I guess that's what you get for pursuing your passion and being brave about it.